Agriculture is our wisest pursuit, and it will, in the end, contribute to real wealth, good morals, and happiness. That is according to Thomas Jefferson. The search for the best farmer 2023 is still going on. And today, we bring to you Nicholas Muhire Lucky, who is an agricultural loans officer, and he is a successful farmer. Welcome to the Harvest Money Show. My name is Rosemary Tukundane. Let us kick off our show.
Nicholas Muhire Lucky is an agricultural loans official working with the Centenary Bank Mubende branch, where he was transferred in 2019. He has been doing this job for the past 7 years. Today, Nicholas owns Zani Farm that sits on 7 acres of land, and on this land, he deals in both animals and crops. But the main enterprise is animal husbandry. In the animal section, Nicholas has dairy cattle, goat, and poultry. On the side of dairy cattle, he has 16 dairy cattle, and by the end of this program, you will see how the cows have managed to change his life, and now he is thinking of retiring from his job as an agricultural loans officer at the bank and concentrate on his farm.
Where we are, we are at the farm called Zani Farm, whereby the name was driven by Who Am I Farm. And here where we are mainly in dairy production, where we do dairy and goat rearing, mainly on dairy, where we have our customers here in Mubende municipality. Mainly we supply people with hotel. We also supply mainly our major customers is women with children, those who are about to get out of breastfeeding. So they are major customers of mine because they are assured that there will be nothing like addition of water. And after here, after getting manure, we put them in the composite site where we also do its composition, and then later we refill it back into the garden.
But what inspired Nicholas to start his farm, and when did he start it?
To me, I was raised while looking after animals, but this particular farm, we started it in 2020. We bought here in 2019. In April is when we introduced our first animal, this one. And from there, it was giving us average 8 to 9 liters per day. And then we said we can push it in up to further. So currently, from 2020-2023, now we have come increasing, buying one by one, whereby now currently, but the one which are born here, we have around 6, and other they are mothers. So we have been increasing, buying one by one, just looking for identifying the right one. And we brought it here. So here in 3 years' time, we have managed to increase from 1 up to 16. And we don't take that one for granted. We thank God. Surely he has been on our side.
When starting up any business, one of the key elements that is needed is capital. Nicholas shares his story of how he managed to go against all odds and start a farm using his savings from his salary.
I never gave myself a loan. Maybe how I raised my capital. Immediately when I started working, I knew what I wanted to invest in. So in that process, it stopped me from rushing to Kampala to look for a 50 by 100 plot. I started hearing about His Excellency Museveni. He was talking about 4-acre model method. In that 4-acre model, when I read about it, he was saying that minimum you need 4 acres. If you have 4 acres, one for your family, another one for animal, another one for crop. So there I started raising money. I asked people, how much is per acre? Then from there, they were like, acre is averaging between 3 to 7 million. So it's when I said, okay, now 21 million, on 21 to 40 million, I can be in position to raise it. So I started saving. So when I saved up to my money of 40 million, it's when I said, okay, let me go for my passion. And then immediately, I never tried to wait. That's why you are seeing the structures I'm using. They are not all that expensive to say that they also had to dig in money. So now I started now the money from the milk, reinvesting it in the project. That's why you are seeing its growth. So whereby now the capital initially, it was a loan.
Great achievements are usually born out of great sacrifice, and never is it a result of selfishness. To start this farm, Nicholas had to sacrifice to achieve what he has today.
Because I knew what I wanted, I had to sit down with the family. We agree on how certain things we should stop ourselves. If she could see me not making her try to look nice on the air, she had to accept. And also I said, if I don't buy a new shoe, so I had to accept. You know, in family, in Africa, we usually have extended families. I also told them, I say, for this period, since I'm going here, you first allow me, I gather myself. So it was not easy, because surely it's stopping what you want, to start saving for what you really are looking for. It's painful. At times you feel its pains, but because you want to add something on this, you have to really sacrifice.
To be a farmer is to be a student forever, for each day brings something new. That is why managing a farm is never an easy task. Nicholas shares how he has been able to do this on his farm.
So when we talk on management, my day generally starts at 5. From 5 up to 6, I'm preparing myself for milking and milking time to see. Then as from 6 up to 6:50, we are done with milking and packing milk. So after packing milk, from 6 is when my workers, all of them, I said to them, start cutting pastures that they are supposed to chop pastures to be fed to yet animals. And those pastures, they collect them a previous day. Because in them, since we have confined them here, we need to balance diet for them, whereby we look at carbohydrates, protein, and these other minerals. So in that process, here we have gardens where we cut our pastures, and in the process, we scavenge along the road. So all of them, we come and rationalize. Then from 9 is when they start feeding in these animal to be starting feeding them. Then because we expect now from 7 up to 9, that is the ample time that they have prepared. So whereby here on average, each animal, we estimate it to be taking around 50 kilograms of pastures. when it is not dry matter content, just when it is fresh. Then after feeding them from there, they start cleaning the area. Then from after cleaning, it's when they, after cleaning, they go for lunch and breakfast. Then after lunch, they go back to the field to correct the pastures which are supposed to be fed animals the next day. But mainly me, I make sure at the feeding time I'm there and milking. I myself am the one who handles those teats. So I'm sure the no contamination, no addition of water, so that my customer gets that exactly what he really pays.
Out of the 16 cows on Zani farm, Muheri only milks 3, and it is from this that he gets 40 liters of milk per day. But how does he sell this milk, and what breeds does he keep on the farm?
So far we are producing 40 liters per day, and those 40 liters where we sell averagely each 1,800, being near the town. And our target, we are targeting in next 2 years, we want to have 100 liters per day. So whereby these parent stock, we are leading to go into Jersey, whereby we shall be only looking for Jersey. That's why we bought in those two Jersey bulls, that they will be crossed with these ones. These are crosses between Frisian and locals, so that we have that animal which has high bad fat content, at the same time giving us maximum also on consumption. It doesn't consume like the full Frisian. And also our environment where we are in Mubende, those Frisian, they like cool environment, but for Jersey, which they are also adaptive.
Security and biosecurity are one of the parameters for one to become the best farmer in 2023. We asked Nicholas how he manages to keep his farm safe and secure.
Currently, we sleep on the farm. That is the first security we have, whereby within my boys, they sleep around the structures. And we have also have dogs, which will try to alert us in case of anything. But in future, we are planning to employ the security guard who will always be alert 24 hours. Yes. On biosecurity, we have there on the gate is usually by a chemical where we dip our feet, but unfortunately, sometimes it came to know that now diseases have reduced, so we stopped. Now we contacted our vet advisors that we brought in somebody who should construct for us the deep where we need to always put all everything of ours at a go before accessing the farm, but which I know in 2 weeks' time. That's why these workers are here. They have come to work on that, and I'm sure it will be done.
Conserving the environment should be always at the front when carrying out any activity, because with poor climate, nothing can go on. It is key to the sustainability of agriculture in our country. But has Muheri been able to do this on his farm?
I am one of the person who loves nature. That's why, like, out of 7 acres, 2.5 acres have been preserved. It remain planted there eucalyptus tree, mainly to make sure that the nature is not tampered with. And here, when we collect the manure Later we shall go there and I show you how we go through this process. I know in animal they are the one that emit methane. But here, when we go in the process of proper decomposition, we cover to make sure that there is no more emission or loss of nitrogen, which is within manure up to atmosphere. And we make sure that by the process, when we finish the proper decomposition, the environment is not tampered with. We are in a position to apply manure at its right stage where nitrogen or humus is ready to be used. So that's why, and around, when you see around, you see all over the trees and where we are, even that's why, because of the animals living in the nature, there are even a mango tree under this shade. So that's why we could never try to carry anything with environment. And we are planning to make sure we use live fence in addition on planting those trees and protecting the environment.
Good farm hygiene and sanitation aim to minimize the introduction and spread of pests in the farm environment. How is Muhire keeping this on his farm?
When we talk of dairy, if you are not clean, please don't go in dairy production. Because that is the first key. The moment you try to contaminate or any environment, when it is dirty, immediately you know diseases will never end from your farm. So one, there is one person specifically who makes sure that every day he makes sure that the animals are, where they sleep, that environment is cleaned every day. And in that day, he doesn't wait in the evening. In the morning, he cleans. After lunch, he cleans. And in evening, he brings in the beddings for the animal, because the rest beddings, we just remove them and replace them. So that we try to control mycetes, so that we also try to control flies. I think wherever we are, we have not encountered many flies or what, but at least that's how. And my wife, Madam Agor, she's in charge to make sure that daily she supervises that hygiene or cleaning of the farm.
Family involvement is very key when you are doing your day-to-day work at your farm. On Muhire's farm, the wife is responsible for feeding and hygiene on the farm. On Muhire's farm, the wife is responsible for feeding and hygiene on the farm. We caught up with Doreen Komuhimba, and this is what she had to tell us about how she manages feeding on the farm.
We have some pastures which we planted. We have Kakamega and Spanapia. Then we also have a legume. It is called lab lab. Then we mix lab lab with those. We can cut Kakamega or Spanapia. When you mix those, the lab lab with the Kakamega or Spanapia, the milk increase. Then we feed them 3 times a day. We start at 11, then after feeding them at 11, then also at 1, and at 3 in the evening, 3 times.
How does Doreen manage the hygiene at the farm?
We work there with my workers in the morning and in the evening.
Doreen tells us the challenges she has faced doing this job.
Challenges are there because we don't have enough pasture, which we have already planted. Then we go around looking for them. We find that we sometimes feed them late because of not having enough pastures. That's why we have decided to plant more.
Challenges make you discover things about yourself that you never really knew. So what are these challenges that are faced by Nicholas on his farm?
Challenges, the first challenge is in labor, whereby whenever we bring in these workers, you find that the moment you train him or her, after saying that you have trained him on milking, on animal production, on management, the next day he will tell you that he is going away. And now you find out again you had to look for another one train. Another challenge is getting the right breed. Because like for the beginners, most of the time you always want to have that animal which gives you the highest milk expect. But whenever you go there, you will get an animal, somebody telling you that it will be giving you 20 liters. But reaching here, it gives you 2 liters. And also sometimes the unreliable vet. When your vet is away and you try to outsource, you find very difficult. They can't really come on time. Then on mechanization, you buy machine expensively, and it reaches here, it works 1 month, it's down. So if there is a way whereby maybe government can try to subsidize on those machines, that maybe we can acquire them cheaply, and maybe is in a position that in case it gets problem, the other person will be in position to replace it, it could be better. Also, because here, mainly we don't chop, we use those machines, they use fuel. And the prices for fuel is always high. So you find that fuel vis-a-vis the liter of milk, at times they do not try to tarry. But we are trying our best to make sure we work within, and there is a challenge. Whenever they come in, those are the things that try to make me wake up to see how can I overcome this. And that's what has kept moving me.
How many workers do you
have? On this farm currently, we have 7 workers. We have 3 who are responsible for collecting the animal feeds. And the other 2, they are in garden, planting for those pastures, weeding, so they are mean. Then 1 is the one who is here, making sure that there is maximum hygiene.
Today, Nicholas earns 1.5 million shillings every month from his farm of 16 cows. And he says that this is pushing him away from his professional job so that he can concentrate fully on his farm. In our next episode, we shall still bring you Nicholas Muhire to tell us how he earns from cow dung from his farm, where he sells 300 bags at 20,000 shillings. The search for the best farmer 2023 is still going on. This has been the Harvest Money Show. Till next time, bye-bye.